Hi friends, welcome to Commoner Series. Throughout the history, many rulers have ruled Indian subcontinent. But among them, only few have hailed as empire builders and ruled over a long period of time in a significant space. For example, in ancient India, Ashoka ruled the entire Indian subcontinent effectively. In medieval period, Akbar hailed as an emperor builder. Unfortunately, in modern India, there is no such ruler because of the over-dominance of the British rule in India. But in spite of that, in 1700s to 1800s, two rulers have raised above the contemporary princely state rulers. One is Maharaja Ranjit Singh and two is Tipu Sultan, the Tiger of Mysore. In this video, we will discuss about the curious person called Tipu Sultan. But why suddenly Tipu Sultan? After his demise, over 220 years, he still managed to hit the national media attention and headlines. So, who is really Tipu Sultan? Succeeded Hyder Ali in 1781 to 82 as a ruler of Mysore. Tipu was a multifaceted and versatile personality. His intellectual greed is reflected in his various interests in the subject, ranging from shooting, horse riding, and he even maintained a personal library in which, after his demise, over 2000 books were shifted to Oxford and Cambridge libraries as reference books, where the subjects ranged from maths, science and astronomy. In his 17 years rule, his reforming hands touched various aspects of administrative sphere. In economic sphere, he introduced new coins, new land revenue settlement and organized the taxations. In defense sphere, he organized his military and trained them in modern European lines. He established modern arsenal in Dindukkal. These are some important administrative reforms by Tipu Sultan, to name a few. He was a keen observer of international issues around him. In that regards, he got inspired by French Revolution and its motto, Liberty, Equality and Fraternity. Thus, he planted Tree of Liberty in Srirangapatnam and opened Jacobian Club of Mysore in the lines of Jacobian Club in France, and he called him proudly as Citizen Tipu. Due to his bravery and independent nature, he naturally became the enemy of British Raj, and he himself considered British as a threat to his sovereignty and legitimacy. This resulted in four Anglo-Mysore wars, but particularly in the third and fourth Mysore war ended up disastrously for Tipu Sultan. In third Anglo-Mysore war in 1789, in Treaty of Srirangapatnam, he ceded almost half of his territory to British and paid a huge war indemnity, about 4 crores. Finally, in 4th Anglo-Mysore War, in the Battle of Srirangapatnam, he met an hero's death. In this regards, he lived his life through his motto, which is, it is better to live like a tiger for a day than to live like a sheep for 100 years. Though an adversary, British admired his defense innovations, particularly his Congruvian rockets, which had a range of 1 km. This technology was later used by British in Napoleonic Wars. So, who is really Tipu? Is he an independence fighter as claimed by early nationalists, or is he a religious bigot claimed by East Indian Company? A versatile personality like Tipu Sultan can't be viewed in a single prism. It is an undeniable fact he involved in forceful religious conversions and destroyed many temples and churches. But it is equally true that he defended Sringeri Math against the attack of Marathas in 1791. He also granted generous donations to Hindu temples in and around Mysore. So, if we critically analyze the Tipu, his moves were merely aided by the expansion and survival of his state Mysore. In this regards, he is neither an independent fighter nor a religious bigot, but only a medieval king who ruled his subjects in a modern mindset. Thank you.